AirPods. Love them or hate them, they have very quickly become the most popular wireless headphones in the world. Like, that's not even an exaggeration. They're everywhere now. So to say there was a lot of hype about AirPods 2 would actually be an understatement. I was actually on a flight recently and the flight attendant recognized me and she wanted to ask just one tech question. And the one thing she wanted to know was when I thought AirPods 2 were gonna come out. So now they are finally here. Second generation AirPods. So to people familiar with the first AirPods, it might not be obvious what's different about these or what makes them different in any way. So I'm here to tell you literally everything that is new. Also, side note, can we look at this box for a second? It still name drops AirPower on the side of the new AirPods box. Come on, Apple, you troll. Anyway, all right, so first of all, these cases. You can get it in three different variations. AirPods 2 with the wireless charging case, AirPods 2 with a normal case, or just the wireless charging case by itself, which can be an upgrade for your current AirPods, which is pretty cool. And they also now offer free laser engraving on any of them, which is dope. So the main advantage of this new case, of course, is that it supports Qi wireless charging, which is key. So since AirPower doesn't exist yet, you can now charge these on pretty much any Qi compatible wireless charging pad, which is basically all of them, or even your friend's Android phone that supports reverse wireless charging, if they're feeling like being nice. Now, it won't be super fast. The case itself supports up to 5 watts of wireless charging speed, which is, again, kind of slow, but it's a pretty small battery anyway in the first place, so it should charge up in well under an hour. And they've moved the little LED light to the outside to indicate charge status. So red still means charging up, green means it's full, and white blinking when it's pairing. Oh, and there's a lightning charging port still at the bottom if you want to charge up the old-fashioned way, which will be much faster with the included lightning cable. Also, sadly, this might be a kind of a hint that the new iPhone coming later this year will probably also be lightning and not USB-C. Like, they would just start moving all their accessories to USB-C now if they were planning on that, but more lightning accessories means probably another lightning iPhone. Anyway, then there are the AirPods themselves, which have the exact same exterior design. So you're not missing anything here. No new colors, no new coating, no new special waterproofing. The stocks aren't shorter or anything. The mics are the same. Like, it's the most un-Apple move in a long time where there's no way to tell if someone's wearing the new AirPods or not. They're literally dimensionally exactly the same. So what is different? Why are these AirPods 2? So internally, inside the AirPods, they now have what's called the H1 chip. That's an upgrade to the previous W1 chip. H stands for headphones, apparently. And these gives you a couple of things. It improves sync for things like video and gaming, so lower latency, which is always welcome in the wireless world. And you now also get faster pairing and switching between Apple devices, so your iPhone and your Mac or your iPod, etc. You get better audio processing that results in better microphone quality for those long phone calls. And then last but not least, you get a longer battery life. So with the same size battery, you actually get up to 50% longer talk time than the current AirPods, so from 2 to 3 hours on the phone, which in the battery department, honestly, is a pretty impressive increase year over year without actually making the size of the earbuds bigger. And they now also support Hey Siri, so it's always listening, always on, anytime. Now, pro tip, you can disable Hey Siri in your settings, which if you use it all the time, then you probably don't want to disable it. But if you do, you can get longer battery life since it's not always listening. But just know that it's tied to your phone's always on settings. So if you disable Hey Siri on your phone, then it disables it on the AirPods. If you enable it on your phone, it enables it on the AirPods. One switch for always on listening everything. Also, something else new, but not necessarily on the spec sheet. These support Bluetooth 5.0 now. They will still connect to Android phones. I did a whole video all about AirPods on Android. But still won't work quite as well as on an iPhone, obviously. And that's about it. Everything else about these is literally exactly the same. Same shape, same exact sound. Same exact sound. Apple confirmed this to me. No different there. They still look like this in your ears, but you're probably used to seeing these now around anyway. Like I said, they're literally the most popular wireless headphones in the world now. They do get more expensive if you want the whole thing, if you want the wireless charging case. But if you have your current AirPods and you just want wireless charging, it's $79 just for the wireless charging case. I think we were all hoping for like some aesthetic or visual change for AirPods too. I was hoping for like a matte black or some sort of colors or anything like that, but that's not a thing. If you do want to add some color or stealth out maybe your first generation AirPods, you can check out a skin from our channel sponsor Dbrand. That'll at least let you customize the look of the case, which is pretty cool. There's also a leak of these new Beats Truly wireless earbuds coming out that might be interesting to a bunch of people as well. I think I want to check those out because AirPods never really fit my ears very well in the first place. If I run around or move a lot, they'll fall out. But these are the safest second gen Apple product in a long time. They're like AirPod 1.0.0.0.1. Super simple. But if you were in charge of a company that suddenly found themselves with the most popular wireless headphones, it's kind of a if it ain't broke, don't fix it strategy. We'll be waiting a little while longer for any sort of significant change to these. But for now, I think I'm gonna go back to some earbuds that actually do fit my ears. But until the next one, that's been it, AirPods 2. Thanks for watching. Catch you guys in the next one. Peace.